Hello, fossil lovers. We are back here for round two of the Pyrite Ammonite prep. Today we are mostly be polishing fossil ammonites. Just get my mask on and we'll get going. We're pretty much there. Just a little bit more of this pyrite bloom to remove, and then we can get on and start using the wire brush, and I might give the bench grinder a go, see what that does. Looks pretty amazing so far anyway. Let's see what else we can do. Alright, so we're getting there. Unfortunately, there's a lot of mud inside of this bit. I'll probably see if I can grind it down. But I might lose quite a chunk of off of this. Also, this part seems to be full of mud. I'll give it a brush down. Look at the gold. Beautiful. I'm going to give this a little go with Dremel now with the brass, not brass, sorry, I mean steel brush. Give this a little bit of a clean up and see what we've missed and come back to it with the engraver. Top tip with these things, put some super glue around the edge. The super glue will stop the bits flying out half as much. But always wear eye protection. Gold! I like gold. Unpolished. Started to polish. Start to see that gorgeous golden shine now. We can see here it's either dense or parts that haven't fossilized. Oops. That are full of mud. These bits here are still bits of the either the original shell or where the pyrite skin starts to form. Pop them off again in a minute. We'll get the engraver with the pin to pop these off again. Center's not quite there. Right. Start giving this side a go. Well, let's switch it up a bit. Let's try using the bench grinder with a sizer wheel and see what difference the bench grinder makes to removing this bloom stuff compared to the wire brush wheel. Polish with the bench grinder. It's okay, it's shiny, it's taken off some of the matrix, but more, it's just buffed everything smooth. Metal wheel, steel brush on the Dremel, this side nice and golden shiny, this side still nice and shiny, but you can still see lots of matrix bloom. These taking off. I'm going to go back at this with the wire wheel. Personally, I think that worked out better for now. Right. So you can see we're getting through to the nice pyrite now. Come on, camera. Still a little more matrix to remove. A little bit there. Just need to charge up the POS before the battery dies. Give that a little look at. So now I'm going to get the engraver. Still a little bit of matrix just sticking on there. Not sure about that hole. I'm sure there must be some solid pyrite behind there. There are sparks coming off of that. Sorry, my voice is muffled. I'm wearing a mask. Still, I think we can get a bit more in the centre with the engraver. So, here it goes. So, do I, don't I? I stay that bit back on. Good old super glue out. I was just thinking about grinding this and reshaping it so that it doesn't break off. Should have done it straight away. Because what does it do? Breaks off. This bit will probably just rot off anyway, more than likely, but I'll come to that road if it gets to it, if it rots. This bit is annoying. Shame it's not solid. I don't want to keep taking that out and putting a big hole in the fossil. I'm just going to change my nib again for a nice sharp one. So we get a few little bits off of there. A few more bits off of that. We'll see if we can get into some polish. So again, we use the cheap old needle. Probably better if I bought better quality, they probably last longer. But I'm a tight ass. I think I'm saving my doing a deal, probably not. My cheap needles. Dispose of that properly. Got me getting that in my tyre. Pop a needle in there. She's good. Still think I could probably get a bit more into that centre. Hopefully without destroying it. That side's a bit better. Here we go. Mask on. Centre's looking pretty good. I think that's it for round two. Join me for round three.